Tom Daschle, we talked about the president. What changes does Barack Obama have to make in this new environment?
Well, I think there has to be more of a conciliatory mood. There has to be a, you know, we were talking earlier about words and what how the president described the election. I think what's more important is action. I'm hopeful that the meeting that he's going to hold this week will lead to a commitment, not only on maybe legislation, but on process, on how we start communicating more effectively. It's maybe hard for some to become more inclusive, to become more engaged, to become more personal. But I think in this case, it's essential to good governance.
Is this what happens to
Insler? I think so.
Do you think that will change?
I think it could. This is the president's last 2 years. He can make history on a whole array of issues. Really some important contributions to public policy. But the only way that's going to happen now, especially, is the realization that it's got to be a partnership. Democrats and Republicans figuring out a way to work together, figuring out a way to find common ground. I think it's possible.
Would it be helpful in seeking that common ground if the president deferred any action until sometime next year, if then, on an executive order on immigration? Mitch McConnell says if he did that now, as he says he's going to, it's like waving a red flag in front of a bull. Should he defer action in the interest of this common ground?
Well, I think it's important that he take into account, how do I accomplish the most common ground I can? I'm not sure that that's necessary. He could take small steps. He made a commitment that he was going to do something before the end of the year. And violating that commitment to a large segment of the American people, I think, might be a mistake. But it can be the first step. It can be an installment.
Small.
He could say, look, I'm starting here, but I really want to give a chance to this common ground opportunity that we now have on immigration to do something that actually would be in statute rather than an executive order. And that would be a far more meaningful and impactful approach. So I think it's not necessarily an either or. I think he can do both. He made the commitment. I think he needs to keep it. But I think that could be just the first step to a series of things that could be done that could be very helpful.
Senator Lott, weigh in on any of this, but I wanted to ask. Well, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Well, no, I was just going to ask you. We talked about that President Obama needs to change.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Does Mitch McConnell need to change some too?
I think so.
And
I think
how?
He needs to be more accessible and more aggressive. Bill Clinton and I, you know, it went both ways. He called me regularly. I didn't hesitate to call him. I used to call and talk to President George W. Bush at 7:20 in the morning because I knew his staff wasn't there, and I could talk to him and tell him some things that I thought were important or maybe needed to hear, but the staff didn't want me to tell him. So, you need to initiate the calls. Get over the insults, well, I wasn't invited to this, or, do it yourself.